Tonight on Times Over Schools Today, we'll take a look at how one man is selling cars at 100 years old.
And as always, we'll have a look from some of the events around the school district. Times Over Schools Today starts in 2 minutes.
Hi, I'm David Jordan. You're watching TV 21, the Times River Regional Schools channel.
Hello, and welcome to Times River Schools Today for Monday, March the 23rd. I'm Jackie Sweeney.
And I'm Dylan McGilloway. Later on tonight, we...
But up first tonight, we take a look at our elementary schools in our elementary happening segment.
Starting off with elementary happenings, please bring your food for donation to Westover for Food Drive Friday. You're helping go a long way.
Let's take a look at today's random fact of the day.
Hi, I'm RT Tour at TV21's random fact of the day. Did you know the $5 bill is slightly heavier than every other denomination of paper U.S. currency?
A Wyoming man loves being a car salesman so much he's been doing it for nearly 7 decades. Daryl Alexander sold his first car in 1949, and he's still selling at 100 years old. Ray Bogan was there to celebrate the birthday milestone.
Customers lined up in White's Mountain Chevrolet, but this time, not to buy. They were wishing an old friend a very happy birthday.
You always brought a whole bunch of
Daryl works 6 days a week and doesn't take vacation. He even sings to the young guys who say they need a day off.
Pick a fun time to leave me, Lucille.
He says being happy in life is simple.
He's upstairs.
When it comes to selling, he claims he doesn't have a secret, at least one he'll share. But his customers say it's honesty, like Alan Sword, who got tired of waiting for his wife in surgery, left the doctor's office, and came back with his first new car, a Chevrolet from Daryl.
If you know him, he's a great guy.
Maybe I've missed sales and I didn't lie to him, but that's okay.
His family is proud and says Daryl has always put his family first. They feel blessed to celebrate his 100th birthday with him.
It's amazing. I never in a million years thought it.
Will Daryl ever retire? Doubtful. His son-in-law says, although it's not as easy as it used to be, he'll work to the day he died.
And I think someday, what he wants is to be sitting there in front of that fireplace, and that's his last day.
But for now, there's still a strong fire in Daryl's heart.
It's time to take a trip around the world on our 60-second road trip. Can you guess where we are today?
Now time for us to take a look at the dictionary.com's word of the day. Today's word is obstinate, meaning perversely adhering to opinion, purpose, or course in spite of reason, argument, or persuasion. And now time for today's sentence. As usual, Uncle Mitch remained obstinate in his opinion even though the facts were clearly stacked against him.
Now we're going to take a short break, but coming up later we take a look at our immediate happenings.
We'll also take a look at your weather, so stick around, we'll be right back.
Mini bar's right over there. Phone if you need to use it. Bed. And what is that?
Oh, that's a double chin.
The guy who checked out must have lost it just snacking on fruits and vegetables. Have a good stay.
Does retirement have to wait until my 70s?
Is a great college for our kids?
Out of the question.
Is the American dream?
Out of our reach?
Not if we can help it. We're the National Endowment for Financial Education, a nonprofit organization dedicated to helping people just like you get smart about their money. Log on to smartaboutmoney.org today and start taking control of your financial life.
Welcome back. Starting off our intermediate happenings at Intermediate South and Seminole Spirit Day every Friday. Don't forget to wear your Seminole colors. Spirit Wear is on sale in the school store.
All students are reminded if they would like to see any sporting event at Intermediate South, you must go home first and then return to the game time with an adult.
At Intermediate North, the warm coat drive extends through the winter months and has been expanded to include sweatshirts.
Switching to Intermediate East, interactive collecting box tops now through May 1st. The homeroom that collects the most wins an ice cream party. Please send your box tops to G113 on May 1st.
Attention Math Club and Math Team members, the next meeting will be Thursday, March 26th in A108 into late buses. All members should attend for information about yearbook pictures.
The Poetry Slam contest will take place in the Media Center on Wednesday, April 23rd at 6:30 p.m. If you would like to enter, please bring your personally written poem to Ms. Mandel in B102 by April 1st. You do not have to be a member of the Literary Club in order to enter. There will be prizes for first, second, and third places, as well as refreshments for everyone.
It's now time for Environmental Tip of the Day. Each day we'll bring you a tip to help save the environment. Let's take a look at today's tip.
Curtis for TV21's Environmental Tip of the Day. Buy water-efficient fixtures and products. The WaterSense label helps shoppers identify water-efficient products and programs.
Every day on the show, we're bringing you a tip of the day, so stay tuned tomorrow as we give you another way to help save the environment.
Man's best friend, indeed. A dog rescues two people from dangerous rip currents at the beach. David Meckham has a report.
It's a new day on the beach for Nico, a 3-year-old Burmese mountain dog, and considering what took place here a day back on this Ventura County beach, who knows what to expect. Nico's owner, Dan Clark, is still digesting his dog's late Thursday afternoon rescue. Two swimmers caught in a rip current. They yelled for help, and that was that.
He went right out to her, right up to the side of the boogie board, and he swung his body around while he was swimming. And I just said, grab him anywhere you can. And she actually put her arm right around almost his chest. And she's hanging on the boogie board with one arm.
Pure instinct is how the former lifeguard sums it up. And in the end, some pictures of the couple Nico rescued. And although they didn't exchange names on the beach, the couple, very grateful, their young children too.
I was like tearing up when my husband was calling me and telling me, you wouldn't believe what Nico just did, because I know how treacherous it is out here and what a false sense of security it is to be not that far offshore and just get called out and nobody around to help you.
The male swimmer has Nico to thank as well. He was actually trying to swim out to the woman and ended up in these stubborn rip currents himself about 100 yards out. Meanwhile, the Clarks adopted Nico a couple months back from a shelter and that he had no ocean experience to speak of. And they say their experience has shown the breed is not naturally inclined to swimming, but some take to it. They also point to a Newfoundland bloodline, and that breed was once used for life-saving in this very same fashion.
You know, the woman and the gentleman, they were exhausted. And they just looked and says, is that like a trained life-saving dog? I said, this is the first I've ever seen him do anything like that.
They wrote their first letters to each other in high school 6 years ago. One was in a small town in Minnesota, the other in Japan. They just met for the first time this week. Emily Allen was there to capture their meeting on film. She filed this report.
Sending a Christmas card to you. I suppose you'll get it after Christmas.
Oceans kept them apart, but words brought them together.
I will be so very happy to explain everything to you. Would like to know about any American thing.
Rosella Sutton was a high schooler in small town Minnesota when she picked up a pen and found a friend overseas.
How do you observe Christmas in Japan?
They've been in touch for 60 years, but never met. And for her 80th birthday, Sutton gets a gift long overdue.
Oh my goodness! Oh, Maceo!
Yeah, that's right!
So glad to see you.
Oh, what a wonderful surprise.
Me too.
January 1960.
Sutton helped Masayo Lutz learn a new language.
Not easy to write English.
And they taught each other about life on the other side of the world.
Graduated in June and got married in July.
Yeah. Well, I was so surprised to see married.
Friends, family, and life got in the way.
We hoped someday.
But they never lost their keepsakes from their faraway friend.
1951, December.
That was still in high school.
1961.
That's after I was married.
Two pen pals who've become best friends.
Been special for a long time.
For decades, words described life's biggest moments. But in this moment, there are no words.
I can't believe it, but I'm speechless. More than I ever could dream had happened today.
It is now time for another break. Coming up later in the show, we'll take a look at your high school happenings.
Time for schools today. We'll be right back.
And I don't want them to see me, 'cause I don't think that they'd understand. When everything's made to be broken, I just want you to know who I am.
Yeah.
Starting off our high school happenings, the Eastside Theater Company proudly presents How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying. Thursday, March 26th at 7 p.m., Friday, March 27th at 7 p.m., and Saturday, March 28th at 7 p.m. Tickets are $7 each. Tickets will go on sale in all lunch periods from March 16th to March 27th. Please stop by the supervisor's office to purchase your tickets. Come and enjoy the show. Attention staff and students. The school store is now open to serve you. We are stocked with all your Raider apparel needs, including Champion and Under Armour brands. The school store is now open every day from 1:40 to 2 p.m. We also have Yoo-Hoo, Snapple, and water for a dollar, as well as many delicious snacks to help you get you energized for your after-school practices. Stop in soon. It's time to get Raiderized.
Attention juniors and seniors, make sure to stop by in guidance to check out the scholarship opportunities you may be applicable for.
Attention juniors, the NJ Scholars Program is looking for intelligent, motivated students for an intensive, free, 5-week summer residential program. The topic of study will be climate change and the human experience. Interested students should see Ms. Millard in guidance. Any student interested in applying to a service academy, please see Ms. Tamara in guidance.
Attention seniors, is your college coming to visit? Please stop by the guidance office to see a list of college visits and when their representatives will be coming to High School East. Attention all of our wonderful East students. We're looking for leaders with problem-solving communication skills who work with our teachers and parents to improve school outcomes related to student attendance, behavior, and overall school climate. We're holding an individual committee meetings at the end of this month, and we'll love to have you involved. Interested? Check out the flyer in your teacher's classroom or stop by in the main office for further details.
In order to raise awareness for families at High School East affected by cancer, the Interact Club will be selling Raiders Fight Cancer bracelets during lunches for $1 each. Proceeds will support cancer awareness. They're also available in the school store and in guidance. Please see Ms. Weinberger. Please help support this great cause.
The Spanish National Honor Society is selling birthday grams for only $5. You get a balloon, a personalized card, lollipop, and are wished a very happy birthday in the morning announcements. So give your friends a special surprise on their birthday. Order forms can be picked up outside Miss Micah's room in S22. Got talent? Dance, sing, juggle, whatever. Tryouts to the Talent Expo will take place after school in the cafe on Tuesday, March 31st. Please see Miss DeLucci in room C05 for an audition form.
It's now time for us to take a short break. Coming up later, we take a look at your 3-day forecast.
Time for Schools Today. We'll be right back. Starting off sports, ask yourself this question. If you were 86, would you strap on a pair of ice skates and some padding and go play ice hockey? Would you join a hockey league? One Alabama man is doing just that. He's spending his retirement on the ice, and it could land him in the Guinness Book of World Records. Lauren Morrison explains.
About 5 years old, most kids got a pair of skates, probably hand-me-downs, and learned to skate on the ponds in Connecticut.
Fred Hudson has been playing hockey on and off for about 80 years now. Next week, he turns 86. And he's still lacing up his skates.
Get the feeling that you can fly almost.
And scoring goals like this one in the tournament last weekend.
I go out there and play. I make a lot of mistakes. I'm slower than the other guys. But every now and then, I make a play. You know, and that's enough to carry me to the next game.
Some of the guys he plays with now, he actually coached back in the day.
I knew there was a good reason for it. I wanted him around when I came back. I needed somebody to play with.
Of course, hockey comes with bumps and bruises, and over the years, Fred has had to change his game a little bit.
I designed my play to fit my physique.
But at almost 86, Fred refuses to be benched in both the game of life and hockey.
The hockey is, once I get the stuff on and I'm on the ice, it's just all business.
In Huntsville, Laura Morrison, WAFF 48 News.
Let's now take a look at our three-day forecast. Coming up tomorrow, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 39 and a low of 30. For Wednesday, it will be cloudy with a high of 48 and a low of 45. And finally, for Thursday, there is a chance for rain with a high of 61 and a low of 45.
Wrapping up tonight's show, a local pizzeria in Naples, the home of pizza, called up to the Pope's motorcade to deliver a proper welcome after hearing of a craving the pontiff had since taking office. CNN's Becky Anderson has the story.
He may be a proud Argentinian, but that's not to say the man born Jorge Mario Bergoglio, better known today as Pope Francis, doesn't have some distinctly Italian tastes. When asked in a recent interview what he missed the most since taking on the top job in the Catholic Church, the pontiff's reply took some by surprise.
The only thing I would like is to go out one day without being recognized and go to a pizzeria for a pizza, he said.
Hearing of the Pope's visit to the home of pizza, the city of Naples, one enterprising resident decided to make the Holy Father's Day.
While I was making the pizzas for my clients, I heard the Pope's car coming and I got ready. While his car was approaching, I jumped over the fence and I gave him the pizza. And with a smile, he said, thank you.
As it turns out, the Pope isn't the only global icon to have savored the delights of the family business, Pizzeria Don Ernesto.
In 1994, my dad did a little pizza for American President Bill Clinton. And yesterday, when I got to know the Pope was in town, I decided to make a pizza and give it to him as a gift.
Enzo's still waiting to hear whether Pope Francis enjoyed his experience. But the pizza chef certainly has a belly full of pride.
It's really hard for me to understand what I managed to do. Giving a pizza you made with your own hands to the Pope is very emotional. It's really hard for me to express the value of this gesture for a man we really love and value, for a beautiful person full of humanity.
And with clientele like this, perhaps Enzo can expect a heaven-sent boost to his business. Becky Anderson, CNN.
Remember, if you have a story you'd like us to cover,
or if you have an announcement about an upcoming event, please send it to the interschool mail at the TV studio at High School East, or you can email us at tv21@trschools.com.
Also, be sure to tune in to TV21 throughout the day to catch this show as we bring you stories from around the district. Also, please take a look at our website, www.trschools.com/TV21.
Well, that wraps up for tonight's show. For Townsend Schools Today, I'm Dylan McGilloway.
And I'm Jackie Sweeney. Have a great night.